Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. And in today's video we are again going to make quilling earrings of the design of a watermelon. So in case you are new to my channel, you can consider subscribing if you like my videos. The requirement to make the quilling earrings are as mentioned on the screen. So to start making with the earrings, we have to take a white 3mm strip and we have to paste a dark green strip of 3mm size at the end of it. So to make the outer layer of the earring, I am rolling the strips on a glue bottle to make a circle, hollow circle kind of thing. Paste the strip little after every round and you will get this kind of shape. Similarly, make the other part of the pair. The strips I use are of size 3mm and length 23 inches approximately. So to make this shape, the outer layer of the earring, I used two strips of 23 inches each. Inner was white color and outer was dark green color, as I mentioned before. So after this part was done, I started with the fillings thing and I take a dark red colored strip and made a tight curl out of it. The length of this strip was around 12 inches. So I made a coil to put in the center and now I need to make triangular shapes so that I can fill the rest of the part of this inner circle. Now I am making a triangular shape. So initially I took a full length strip and I made a tight coil out of it. Opened the tight coil to make a loose coil and pinched it from one side to make a teardrop. Now I checked that the size was big enough. I mean, it was more than the required size, so I had to cut the strip in the half. Yeah, that means I used around 12 inches strip to make these triangular shapes. This was a teardrop and now I am going to pinch the round part, top round part, to make it a triangular shape. So once I was happy with the size, I made similar few more pieces for cover the insides of this watermelon. So at this stage, my inner parts, inner feeling or whatever we can say it, is almost ready, and I was like checking that it is fitting in my outer circle. It got dry and I am trying to pull it up. We have to be a little patient with the drying process. And in the meanwhile, I am preparing the things for the other pair. By this time my inner things was ready, and now you must be thinking that like what I am doing over here. So what had happened was the circle which I made initially were not fitting this structure. So what I did was I discarded the old circles, and I took the strips again, white and green, and I started rolling them on this structure by hand so that it covers them properly. So this was a learning to me as well, like if we are doing something like this, we have to start from the inner side, not from the outer side. So in this way my earring was completed. I had to do a little bit of rework over here, but it was worth, because every project gives us some new learnings, and we of course learn from our mistakes only. Thank you. Once the earrings were done, it was now part to add loops to it. So here I am adding the loops. So for adding the loop, I had to make a small circle tight coil, and I had to paste it over this the top of the earring, so that loop comes in this circle and it get added to the earring. And here I really don't know what happened to my video. It was on the tripod, my phone was on tripod, and somehow this second video was of low resolution. So here what I'm doing is I'm coating the earrings with a layer of fevicol so that we can protect it from the water and any other damages. This was the last process, and here how they looks after finished. So I hope you like this video, and stay connected. Bye.